Johnson.
Travel girl. She likes to travel and she's a girl. She's always spending my money. Travel girl. Travel girl.
Hello, hello. Travel girl here at Universal Orlando. And this is our review of the Cabana Bay Beach Resort on property. Dad and I have stayed here twice now and had a blast. So let's get started. A few years ago, we ended up losing power for 5 days due to the latest Florida hurricane. Yeah, Florida's a lot of fun.
Stupid Florida!
Anyway, we decided to stay at the Cabana Bay to get away for Dad's birthday weekend. During this emergency though, pets were allowed, so we got to take Callie with us. Note that this was only for the hurricane. Pets are allowed at some of the other resorts. Then last year, we decided to take another trip for a little 3-day getaway. For our recent staycation, we stayed in the Americana wing of the hotel. The room we chose was a 2-queen standard room. They also offer suites for larger families. You can choose different views of Volcano Bay or the pool. I would highly recommend the Volcano Bay view room. It is breathtaking at sunrise and sunset. Cabana Bay has a full-sized bowling alley located on the second floor. We bowled on both of our trips, but it was most appreciated on those hurricane days.
Unpredictable strike right now, little girl.
The pool was our favorite activity, and we ended up going in every day on our getaways. The Atomic Tonic Pool Bar is a must for great frozen drinks to sit back and relax. The resort, especially the pool area, is even more beautiful at night when it's all lit up. On select nights, Cabana Bay hosts a dive-in movie by the pool. You can find out the schedule at the front desk. Inside the diner, they sell s'mores roasting kits that make sure to include everything you need. Groovy alcoholic and non-alcoholic drinks along with snacks can be found at the Swizzle Lounge. Like I did mention earlier, there are great drinks you can grab by the pool at the Atomic Tonic, but you can also get drinks along with burgers, hot dogs, and wings at the Hideaway Bar and Grill. For all you coffee lovers needing your daily fix, Starbucks is located by the lobby on the first floor. If you're staying for at least a couple days, consider getting the refillable cup with free refills at the hotel for your entire stay. The biggest variety of food can be found in a food court called the Bayliner Diner. There's a grab-and-go section as well as a variety of food stations that offers pizza, rotisserie chicken, carved meats, and deli sandwiches. We had a quick dinner here one night, but for the others, we decided to venture around property. For breakfast, we loved going to the kitchen at the Hard Rock Hotel. It has a great atmosphere and delicious food. They made Dad his favorite pancakes, loaded up with pecans. We went over to Margaritaville in City Walk to have a fun dinner and drinks with some friends. Dad suggests the frozen blackberry margarita, while I opted for the mango one. Every time we stay at Universal, we have to go to the Palm Steakhouse at the Hard Rock Hotel. We'll be posting our review of the Palm soon, so keep an eye out for it. Let's get back to the Cabana Bay with our pros and cons. We love the theming of this hotel with its cool retro vibe. We felt like we took a time machine back to old Vegas, except without the mobsters or gambling. The amenities are also a plus, especially the large pool with a lazy river and the retro bowling alley. The price is reasonable for staying so close to the parks. It's not cheap, but it's a good value compared to the other hotels on property. Cabana Bay is the only hotel where guests are given a special entrance to Volcano Bay. We wish there would have been a full-service restaurant in the hotel. We can only imagine what groovy place they could have come up with. be prepared, there are a lot of children here. It's great for families, but if you want something a little more adult-oriented, head over to the Hard Rock Hotel. Finally, unlike some of the other hotels on property, there's no water taxi to take you to City Walk, where you can access the parks. It didn't affect us because we had a car and there are buses, but to some guests, it will be inconvenient. And now for the verdict. I give the Cabana Bay a score of 8 out of 10. Dad also gives Cabana Bay an 8, which gives us an overall score of, you guessed it, an 8 out of 10. We definitely recommend the Cabana Bay Beach Resort, especially if you're traveling with kids or just love the retro theme like we do. How about you? Have you ever stayed here or at another Universal hotel? Let us know in the comments below. Thanks for watching. If you liked our video, please hit the subscribe button and ring the bell so you can be notified of our next video. Catch you on the flip side.